We live in a world driven by the desire to do more, to be more, to have more. A new car, a new sofa, new clothing, new laptop, new game, new haircut, new shoes. Have more experiences, scuba diving, skydiving, climbing, jumping, walking on ropes, read more, do nothing, be assertive, speak up for yourself, have an opinion, listen, solve conflicts, be kind, work for three, relax, lose weight, gain weight, be patient, take responsibility, be active, have fun, get married, have children, and so on. Is it wrong to have the desire? Is it right? What's the price? We try to do more, to be more, to have more at the expense of our health and our well-being. I would like to share with you what happened in 2009 when I was in the second year of university. Then I was a busy girl. University, friends, a job, volunteering work. And after 1 year of being a full-time student, having a demanding job and being a volunteer, I started to feel tired and I couldn't sleep. But do you know, I was young and I thought that my body didn't need so much sleep. And it was fine for me because I had more time to work. Fast conclusion. I also didn't feel the need to eat. And that one, I was very happy because I became skinny. Easy conclusion. And I was also getting sick very often. So I was coughing twice a year, from October to March and from April to September. But do you know, we all get sick. Another easy conclusion. Sometimes I wasn't so happy with the life that I was having, so I started to do more to feel more alive. And I assume that the majority of us also had some of these experiences at a higher level or a lesser level. On a Wednesday morning, when I went to work, I fainted in the subway. Some kind people took me out, gave me some water and some vitamins, and that was the moment when I started to think of myself and reflect. Because I wanted to know why that happened. And I realized that I hadn't had a good night's sleep in the past year. I hadn't eaten any good food, any real food, in the past 2 weeks. And I wasn't so happy with the life that I was having, even if I was doing a lot. But I had fancy clothing. That was the moment when I made the decision to eat food and to drink water, even if I don't feel the need to. My body needs resources. And if I'm okay, I can also support others. Safety instructions. First, put your oxygen mask and then help others. There is also a saying in Romanian. If your tongue gets burned by the hot soup, you will blow in yogurt. And since then, I've been following my decision. Eat 3 times a day. Drink at least 2 liters of water is in my everyday to-do list. After 7 years, in April 2018, it happened again. After a hard day at work, a very demanding one, I was very tired and I couldn't think clearly. And I had a car accident. That was another significant moment for reflection. My body gave me signals, but I didn't listen to them. I couldn't sleep. I was worried. The voice inside my brain was predicting awful scenarios. And I was very stressed. I didn't believe I was stressed. I thought that is the adrenaline and the desire to do more, to be more, to have more. It was actually the way how my body was coping with the situation. I didn't listen to my body. Actually, let's be fair. I didn't want to listen to it. I totally ignored it intentionally because I wanted to do more, to be more, to have more now. The waking moment for me was a car accident. I don't want this kind of significant moments for reflection in my life because I don't know when they are going to be and how. And maybe the next one would be the last one. I want to have some power over what happens to me. And I made another decision to find my pace. Let's take it like this. It's like running a marathon. It's impossible to run 42 kilometers on a sprint pace. If I want to run a 100 kilometers marathon, how should I run it? But if I want to experience a 100 year marathon, how should I live my life to be able to cross the finish life, the finish line, and not to give up after 50 or 60 years? When running a 100 kilometers marathon, it's important to find your pace and to be flexible enough to change it according to the terrain ahead and the conditions. So, last August, I started the process of finding my pace. And I followed 3 easy steps. Easy to remember and to explain, but with important decisions to make. And for these 3 steps, I found inspiration in many books and videos of some of the greatest authors and teachers in the field of personal development. And I would like to thank them for the inspiration. The first step that I followed was to explore what I am good at. Not the things that I would like to be good at, the things that I'm already good at. What do I enjoy doing? What are my strengths? What brings me fulfillment? And to be able to create space for exploring, I had to learn to say no to the things that aren't important to me and they weren't helping me. And some of you might think, selfish. But remember, the mask oxygen, the oxygen mask. And I realized that I really enjoy understanding how we function. To connect the dots, to connect the ideas, to bring ideas, to make things happen, to support, to facilitate, and to speak. Just ask my husband when is the break and he will tell you more about it. So, the first step, explore what you are good at. The second one was my challenge. What can be done at least 80% as well by someone else? That step was my challenge because I like things to be done a certain way. And I'm just one and I can't duplicate myself. So I had to learn to accept support from others and to understand that it's enough just 80%. Things don't have to be done perfectly. And now, you can just ask my husband. He washes the dishes, does the laundry, does the groceries, and I have more time to sleep. And the third step is my favorite one. What do I love doing? What does bring you energy? What is your fuel? And some of you might think, oh, but Gabby, I can live without my fuel with no problem. Let's take it like this. How far does the car go until the tank is depleted? It goes for a while, yes, but after, we are similar. Where is your gas station? Are you on gas, diesel, or do you have an electric engine? We are all different, and it's important to take motivation and inspiration from the things we love doing. For some of you, it might be easy to give yourself time to do the things you love doing. For some of you, not so easy. For me, wasn't. But now I have on my to-do list time to read or to have a walk, to cook, to bake, to do nothing. How are you good with yourself? How do you honor yourself every day? I told you that these three steps is very easy to remember. And we have three words: strengths, support, and fuel. And if you are more visually, we have also three images. Some of you also might think, but Gabby, do you know I have a busy life? I have to sprint. Yes, I also have many sprints in my life. But what do you do after? Do you slow down and recover? Or after a sprint, you start another one and another one and another one without giving yourself time to breathe and recover? When you entered into this room, you received a measuring tape. Now it's time to use it. So, if you have it, what I would like to invite you is to rip it according to your age. I'm 31, so I will rip it at 31. And now, look at it to see how much you have left. And okay. How do you choose to live the rest of the marathon of your life and to hit 100? Maybe some of you don't want to hit 100, or maybe some of you want to live more. But it's your choice, and you can find it in your choices that you make every day. Remember that we are free to choose, but we are not free from the consequences of our choices. Find your pace, enjoy the journey, with the end in mind. Thank you.